Dear friend, this is an exercise inspired to heal past wounds and a way of receiving messages from your ancestors. Start by praying to the world you are part of. You look at trees and call them trees. You may not think twice about the word. You call a star, and think nothing more of it. But please remember that these words are names given to these objects by people far away in time, and with a very different view from yours. To you, a tree or a star are simply materials outside from you, following their mathematical course. But for the first men to talk of trees and stars, the world was alive, full of light beings. They saw the stars as living silver, bursting in flame in answer to the eternal music. They saw the sky as a jeweled tent, and the earth as the womb whence all living things have come. Pray to Spirit, the primary source of creation, to Mother Earth, to your ancestors, and to all the beings of light that are here to protect you. Now settle wherever you feel comfortable, seated on a chair, on the couch, or lying down. Just feel your body melt down where you are. Bring your awareness to this present moment, knowing that there is no other place you need to be at this time, apart from right here, right now. You're going to embark on a journey that goes through the medicine wheel of your ancestors, of the wise ones that have loved you through times. Their soul remains close to you and comes to meet you in today's modern life world. Your ancestors are beloved beings that wish for your highest good and often come to bring you the messages that you need to know at each point. Call upon the medicine wheel of the ancestors to give you back the courage to take any harsh situation that you have in your life and bring it to the wheel where you can process and transmute it. The wise ones will be your guides, as they have been entitled by Spirit to assist their lineage for the highest good of all. Start by bringing in your mind something that you need to find clarity on or understand better. Keep in mind that one thing that you wish to experience in a different way. Say, I wish to bring to light and transmute with the love and support of my ancestors. Now mention whatever you feel you need to process. Now imagine yourself walking past a green field, getting slightly downhill to a valley. Take note of the gorgeous flowers, magnificent trees, and any water element around you. Perhaps a river flowing down the valley. Your steps become lighter as you progress, and by the time you get to the bottom of this valley, you take time to notice a perfectly round stone located at a sacred place. big stones placed in a round shape and four larger stones like standing gods close to each other, each one of them representing one of the four directions: east, south, west, and north. In the middle of this circle of stones lies a beautiful stone bed, large enough for you to lie, watching the sky above and the four larger stones surrounding you, keeping the healing energies within the circle. As you come closer to this wheel of healing, with every step you take, you feel overwhelmed by the graceful assistance of your ancestral lineage that has been brought here by your side. Bring more and more into your awareness the situation that you need to find clarity on. You are asking your ancestors to send you wisdom and assist you in experiencing the situation in full conscious awareness. Lie on the stone bed and feel at ease. As you breathe deeply, you allow yourself to connect to the stones around you. Start by placing your attention to the eastern stone and feel the energy of the east. Feel the place of illumination and a new beginning in front of your eyes. See what you want to create in your life. Imagine placing your hands on the giant stone of the east direction. Just feel what happens when the energy of the eastern stone penetrates your body. What shifts in your body as it comes to a new awareness? Let any words rise and describe who you are or how you are in regards to what it is that brings you today here to this valley. Speak out that matter that you hold in your heart and you wish to experience in change. Allow any concepts from your current situation to be expressed now as you stand here in the east. Take notice of an eagle flying above your head. The energy of the eagle is with you now to give you perspective of clarity for your situation. The eagle gives you the warmth of an eye close to the sun as it rises over the horizon. It brings curiosity about life, curiosity about the situation that you bring to the medicine wheel today. Feel gratitude for the eagle's eye as it wants you to acknowledge the energy of the East and receive clarity and wisdom through this journey. Now move slowly to the south direction. Imagine placing your hands on the southern stone that is all about emotion. Feel the passion and the color surrounding you as in a festive. You are being supported by the colors and the heat of the sun that shows its rays on your face. Feel the impulse inside of you rising up from the sacral chakra to your solar plexus. As the sun's warmth is placed on your solar plexus, bring your situation or feeling to the south direction. Feel free from the perspective of each emotion concerning your situation, of whatever makes you angry or hurt you, of whatever disappoints you or is without love and joy. Allow yourself to feel joyful and reach the level of pure love that you wish for yourself and others. Ask to see a sign or a symbol, a being or an animal that will bring you what you need to learn from experiencing this emotion right now. All emotions are here to serve you and teach you lessons. And if you can learn this lesson and feel gratitude for this emotion, you will be able to release it in case you no longer wish to carry it with you. Just take a deep breath and at the end of that breath say it loud or see it in your mind's eye. I release this emotion now, whether it is anger or fear. I just feel how it exits my body with every exhalation. You gently let it go, as it has already served its purpose. While you stand at the south direction, feel the energy of the dolphin, the friendliness of this lovely sea creature, and be grateful, for it brings you the vitality and flexibility of the south direction. Now gently make your way towards the west direction. This is the place of transformation, of death and rebirth. Imagine placing your hands on the stone of the west and feel how shifts are coming to your body. By touching this stone, you take notice of any tensions in your body from the emotion that came up in the south. Emotions might reside deeply inside you and have now arisen. Turn your attention there and consciously send your breath there to relax. Now physically place your hands on that place on your body and say, I am helping myself bring my awareness to what I need to do in my life in order to fully release, understand, or experience rebirth. I consciously release everything that no longer serves me. I let go of that part of my life that keeps me back. I allow to reborn. I kill myself to soften my edges. As you release yourself from old patterns, bring your awareness back to the west direction. The energy of the phoenix, the great bird that rises out of the ashes, brings awareness of the circle of life and death. It is the eternal renewal, the gift of spirit for your evolution. The energy of the snake is also with you, shedding its skin, transforming as it follows seasons and time, bringing into your body the effect of energy transmutation. Feel gratitude emanating from your body as the soles of your feet grow roots into the earth. Breathe in and out slowly. Now move slowly and gently, putting your hand on the northern stone. Feel the rays of perfect nightlight coming down, entering from your crown, illuminating your headspace and allowing you to become more connected to the spiritual world. Let come to your mind's eye any question that you need to be answered. Ask for any clarification, any insight, inspiration, as now your beloved ancestors dive down into your soul to assist you in opening the communication channel with spirit. Bring to your awareness the energy of the bear. The bear is hibernating in the winter and connects to the energy of the source, allowing itself some time of reflection. From hibernation to resection, the bear gains the wisdom and the knowledge to come back to action again. Allow the spirit of the bear to support you at this point of gently coming back to life. Now stand up and exit out of the medicine well. Take a moment to express gratitude to your soul family and place your hands down on Mother Earth. Say, "Thank you, Great Spirit," and know that the One is the One since the beginning of time.